If you are looking to tackle a DIY project where you want to frame and insulate a shipping container into some sort of structure, there are a few ways to do it. My favorite is steel stud brackets, steel studs, and spray foam, but a lot of people either can't afford spray foam or it's just not accessible to them. For that, we have come up with a few different products to help you with your framing project and simplify the whole process and take away a lot of that thinking for you. So here we have our wood stud brackets. This is what you see just above me here. This is wood framing across the ceiling. Now you can do that and actually switch back to steel studs to the right of me here, or you can utilize steel studs entirely. And there's a few different ways to do this. So stay tuned in this video. I'm gonna walk you through them. Let's go from worst to first. I strongly suggest you don't use wood studs, but if you're gonna do it anyway, these wood stud brackets are amazing. They have so much thinking built inside of them that's done for you. It measures how long you need to cut your wood. It defines your interior wall plane. It installs very nicely up into the top tubing, and it makes sure that all your wood is away from the outside walls, giving that whole wall assembly a chance to breathe, limiting the chance of your walls wicking that condensation and growing mold inside of them. But if you're willing to take on that risk, here they are. They work great, and you'll be using a wood 2x4 to both go across the ceiling and frame downwards. So once you get them installed all in the ceiling, whether you go 24 inches on center or 16 inches on center, you can then choose, do you want to come down with the wood or the steel stud? And if you use wood, depending on the wood stud spacing that you've selected, you can buy your batten insulation. Now, please at least do me this favor and choose mineral wool insulation. Don't use fiberglass, because this stuff, when you dip it in water, it doesn't wick that water up it, but fiberglass will wick it from floor to ceiling, and then you've absolutely soaked all of your wall members. So don't do that. Make sure you use mineral wool insulation. Hopefully you're in a dry area. If you're in Florida where it's absolutely super humid, this is gonna cause a problem. If you're in the north, up here in Canada, where it's disgustingly cold in the middle of winter and you're trying to keep this at 20 degrees, you got like a 70 degrees Celsius temperature delta inside of here, it's gonna cause problems. But maybe if you're in a mild climate, you can get away with it. A little bit better of a method, if you're not using spray foam, is to use steel studs. So these steel studs here utilize a steel stud bracket. These specific brackets, they install up in the top tubing, very similar to these wood stud brackets. But these allow you now to snap your top track into these steel stud brackets and install your bottom track, and then just snap all your steel studs in. These work great with 1 5/8 steel studs and spray foam, because it allows you to get a nice, perfect vapor barrier all the way around everything, and you got yourself a Yeti cooler inside of a shipping container. But if you don't use spray foam, you can use 2-inch mineral wool insulation. So this here, in a 2 1/2-inch steel stud, stuffs very nicely inside of this steel stud, and that gives you a pretty common layer of insulation aside from your one thermal bridge every 24 inches. So that's gonna work very well for a soundproofed envelope. So this thing here, if you were a drummer and you needed a place to jam and your parents didn't like you in their basement, it would work very well. And this, at least being a non-porous stud and insulation that's resistant to mold and mildew growth, you do have a fighting chance in hell of keeping yourself safe. But again, my ultimate recommendation is that 2-pound closed cell spray foam insulation. But this here is a couple different methods to show you other ways to insulate, ways that we don't do it here at the Container Guy, but ways that you can do it. These are ways that are familiar with yourself. If you're not familiar with steel studs, you elect to use 2x4s, push yourself. Try the steel studs, try them first, buy a few of them. It's not that hard, and they're very editable. So you can actually move them around after they're installed. It's a lot different than a wood stud, especially if you were building these walls outside, air nailing them all together and then bringing them in here. If you want to move that stud later, get out the sledgehammer. You're totally destroying the stud, or you got to take the whole wall assembly out and be very cautious with your nail puller. So steel studs are the way to go. Both of these brackets here do have similarities. They both use 2 fasteners to mount up into the top 60 millimeter tubing, and they hug that tubing. So it's a positive placement there. You hold that thing up to the tubing and you know that you got it in the right spot. And then they do have also laser cut slots in them. So if you mark all of your 24 or 16 inch on center, or if you're matching the corrugations, which are about 11 inches on center, you can find exactly where you want this stud. And so that is one commonality between them, but the actual material utilized when you're actually framing are vastly different, and here's why. So wood studs and steel studs are different, and there's some advantages to both. Let's talk about the advantages of wood studs. Wood studs are very common practice of framing. Everyone typically knows how to work with wood studs, and they're also very durable. So you can mount a lot of weight through just a regular deck screw, or if you're using a GRK that's got a lot of shear strength, you can mount a whole bunch of weight kind of anywhere on this wall. You got your stud finder out, and make sure you hit one of them bad boys, and you don't have to be a genius to create some sort of a shelving system with that type of wall framing. Let's talk about the disadvantages of wood studs. There's really only one huge disadvantage, and it's a very big one. These things are porous, which means they're gonna wick all that condensation into the stud, cause health concerns. When you get to the steel studs, these things are a lot flimsier, and you might not be a pro at framing with steel studs. But once you get used to working with steel studs, it's actually a lot easier method of framing. And inside of shipping containers, when you don't really know where your windows or your doors are gonna end up, a lot of times you can kind of start framing and then just finish off around that. Where with wood studs, you gotta build your wall assembly typically outside of the shipping container, haul it in and hope that you've measured everything right and it lines up to your windows. So you can slowly work with the steel studs, and they're very light and they're very easy to work with once you figure that system out. So the disadvantages with these steel studs, there's also another big one, is that they're not that strong to fasten into. A lot of times, if you give it one extra chugga-chugga with your impact driver, you should be using a drill. But if you do that, you're just gonna strip the stud out. So there's two different gauges of steel studs. There's the thin, which is more of like an interior wall steel stud, and then there's a thicker one. It's more of a structural steel stud. The thin ones, you can really just drive into them with a wood screw, where the thicker ones, you're gonna have to self-tap, and that's also a little bit of a pain. But if you're planning on mounting a bunch of shelving or something to your steel studded wall, you're probably gonna wanna glue some plywood to the steel studs first, and then now you have freedom and flexibility to mount anything anywhere. And as far as the National Building Code's concerned, if you're mounting things to a plywooded wall, you wanna use 3/4 inch plywood. Just keep that in mind. A lot of times fasteners will rip right out of 1/2 inch or 5/8, but 3/4 is a magic number. So this here is a very cool method of framing shipping containers. This is what it looks like all finished up when we use our wood stud brackets up top. We have wood studs going across the ceiling, and then we've steel studded downwards. So this here is a very soundproof envelope and something you're gonna wanna watch. So make sure you follow along and subscribe to the channel. Make sure you ring that bell for notifications so you can see this video when it comes out. And as always, check us out at tcg.ca. Hope you learned something.